So, first and foremost, I want to give all praises. Well, we want to give all praises to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Hashem, who conquered us. And also, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. They rule well and they taught us everything through the Spirit of God, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And also, salutations to all the Akim out there on the streets, man, and on the unicorn, which is truth and sincerity. And without chair, so I want my name to salute. Right, this is the brothers from the Atlanta County. I'm part of the brothers that introduce themselves.
Oh, yes, brother Taiwan.
Come, this is Tom.
Come, here, hey, we here just to, doing another lesson, sit down and edify, one third, and just a leg, man, because, as we can see, time is short, man, and prophecy is making itself, he's revealing itself, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, because the Lord said, in the time, the visions, in the time, in the end, it will speak, and it will not lie, man, and everything that we've been talking about, it's coming to pass, okay, and that's all the Spirit of power, Yahweh, some of y'all, so I said, humbly, Yahweh, okay, but yeah, it's just happening, man, from the chip. To it's becoming evident that the powers that be, Esau, man, they're gonna roll us hard. The only group of men that's been warning the people consistently about what's coming is GMS, man, Great Millstone, man. Okay? Hey, could someone get Revelations 19:10? Because, hey, these other camps, yeah, it's good to know your Israelite. Yeah, it's good to pick up on your history and know who you are. But more importantly, you need to know what's coming. Because all of these things are being revealed in the last days. So there's more to it that come with it besides knowing who you are. Okay?
Okay.
Go ahead, bro, if you got it.
Okay. The Revelation 19:10. And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, see thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant, and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahweh Shai. Worship the Most High, for the spirit of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy.
That's right. That's the point. On that last sentence, the spirit of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy. Okay? All your other accounts, you say you come from the Lord, Yahweh Shai, but you're not prophesying. You're not prophesying, but yeah, it's good to wait, Jacob. But these are the last times, man. As Romans 13:11 says, man, it's high time to wake out of sleep. These are the last times, man. A lot of things are supposed to be happening right now, and it's happening. But obviously a lot of Israel is asleep. Well, they're not hip to what's going on, man. They need to go hit that button, man. Tap into the spirit. Be more circumspect. Realize who you're learning from. Imminent death is coming. Imminent death is coming. Who warned you of that? Great Millstone. Through what? The spirit of prophecy through Yahweh Shai. Take a better look at the scriptures, man, and distance yourself from the false prophets, man.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to die. You know?
Okay.
Your brother's got any precepts?
I got one for you.
Okay, God.
It's Romans 11:7. What then? Israel hath not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election hath obtained it, and the rest were blinded. All right? And, you know, like the brother's saying, you know, it's a lot of people that just not hit to the fact of what's going on, but at the end of the day, it's really just those are the ones that were blinded. All right, they're not meant to get the understanding. All right, just like you know, we was talking about this at camp yesterday. You know, not everybody's a 2/3, but at the same time, not everybody's 1/3 either. You know, it's a lot of people that's gonna be they have to be destroyed to fulfill the prophecy, like we just read in Revelation 19. All right, a lot of people are just meant to die, and that's just, you know, that's just the reality of the scriptures, man. All right, now whether you believe it or not, that's not, you know, that's not our problem. You know, that's the spirit of the Lord. He'll just jump back in. You know.
Come on, yeah. I got something to back you up on that.
Come on.
This is 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 2 Ezra 9:18. It says, "And now, when I prepared the world, which was not yet made, even for them to dwell in that now live, no man spake against me. For then everyone obeyed. But now this is the the Heavenly Father speaking about, you know, when he created the world, it was in its perfection. Okay? He says, "But now the manners of them which are created in this world that is made are corrupted by a perpetual seed, and by a law which is unsearchable, rid themselves," and that's going back to the time of Adam. You know, that the seed of corruption was sown through the weakness of Cain. Verse 20 says, "So I considered the world, and behold, there was peril because of the devices that would come into it. And I saw it, and I spared it greatly, and have kept me a grape of the cluster and a plant of a great people."
Ooh. Ooh.
Then it says, "Let the multitude perish then, which was born in vain, and let my grape be kept, and my plant with great labor have I made it perfect."
Okay.
And now see, right, you know, basically the Lord, he created all these people in the earth, but he's only going to keep a small cluster of grapes, man,
yeah.
You know, which is the elect of Israel. Meanwhile, the rest of the multitude on the planet is going to die, man.
Yep.
That's why you have to warn the people, because in the prophecies, when you read 2 Ezra 9 chapter, all right, he goes into how in the last days he's going to start manifesting the evils upon the earth, man.
God.
You know, the earthquakes, the fires, the uproars of the people, okay, and other plagues and calamities in the earth. And you got these Israelites out here not warning the people about it, to get the elect of Israel straight to gather in that cluster of grape.
Mm.
You know.
Huh.
But the Lord is going to perform the word that he said, man. Okay? We're not going to be, in America and just teaching this word on the streets forever. We got to understand what's going on, man.
Huh.
Okay? It's the Lord's purposes to destroy a multitude of the people, man. Okay?
Yep.
Hey, he said that the bulk of them that were created were born in vain.
Yeah.
Okay? You know?
Yeah, come.
So, you know, with these other Israelite groups and these other camps outside the Great Millstone, that's just, you know, talking about black people and you know, gathering the black people in and you know, gathering, you know, the tribe, and you're an Israelite and come to my school, and you're not really prophesying and saying what's getting ready to come down the pike here in Babylon the Great. There's something wrong, man.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with you, man. You gotta be out of your mind. The place is gonna go home, man. No. It's not.
Huh?
Huh? You know, it's major this is gonna happen in this earth, and we have to tell the people about them. That's why the Lord said, I've made thee a watchman to the house of Israel. Okay?
Huh?
We watch and we see, you know, we watch the news, we see the events that's going down overseas, around the world, and then we filter everything through the scriptures and say, well, is that a fulfillment of prophecy? You know? And when we see that it's a fulfillment of a particular prophecy, we do a video on it.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
I got a script for you.
We got it out.
Come.
Okay.
It's Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 1. I was set me upon, and then we watch. All right, it's our duty. This is a commandment to tell you people what's coming. All right, the destruction. All right, the famine. All right, the pestilence, the race wars. You know, and it sounds like a broken record, but it's what must be done. You know, it says and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what I shall answer when I am reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, that he may run that readeth it. And that's, you know, that's what we doing, man. Like, you know, when we see some articles or news or events in the news, right, we speak about it and we link it up with the scriptures, man, because that's what we're supposed to do, you know. It says, verse 3, for the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. And that's, you know, and that's what these other groups ain't teaching, man. They're not teaching about the prophecies of the Lord, man. And that's part of that role, that sweet and that bitter. Alright? And you know, this is really an open forum, but at the same time, we really directing this towards you other Israelite camps that's not teaching about destruction. All y'all want to teach is Israel and everybody, you know, salvation. But what about the two the scriptures speak about? There's prophecy in them too. You know, you're not warning the people, man. You're not getting blood off of your hands. You're not saving souls, man. All right, you're not separating the sheep from the goat like the scriptures tell you, man. And that's what we rightly dividing through the spirit, man. You guys ain't doing that, all right? You gonna have a lot of people's blood on your hands. Because you're not doing what's commanded of in the scriptures, man. You know?
Yeah, I got it's more on that script, bro.
Nah, it's it. That's all I wanted to bring out.
Okay, I got a precept. This is 2 Peter 3:9.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slack. So the Lord, what the Lord say he's gonna do is gonna happen, man. Okay, that's why we are so bent on prophecy, okay, because it's going to come. We're saying it before it's happening. We know the Lord is not playing, man.
Yep.
You know how, like, for example, Friday, Smokey and Big Worm. Smokey thought Big Worm was playing, man. You know, man, the Lord not playing. He not slack. When the Lord brings the full judgment down, it's gonna be all this due. It's gonna be heavy, and it's gonna be right on time.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll finish the verse. But it's long suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Okay? And the ones that gonna come to repentance are the one third and the elect, man. But hey, you got to hear. You got to know what's going on, man. You got to accept who your teachers are, who has the truth, regardless of how you feel about how we bring it out. The scriptures tell you to not, don't hate the forward teacher or the gentle teacher, man, loosely paraphrasing. Okay? And to be honest with you, it ain't no easy or gentle way to say what's coming.
Yeah. Right.
Okay. It's like being in a house on fire. And you're gonna say, hey man, come on man, let's go. The house is on fire. Or you're gonna be like, man, get the fuck out of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Get your ass out that window now, man.
Right.
Yeah, hey, that's just a testament to how much we care, man.
Right. Ain't no easy way to tell you that you know, like you said, the house is burning down, or you know, they don't walk into the street, man. It's a damn 18-wheeler coming. You can say, hey, man, don't walk. No, nah, but hey, man, get the fuck out of the goddamn way, man.
That's right.
You know?
Okay.
Hey, I got a preacher real quick.
Okay.
You know, it's a classic right here, man. This is Isaiah 58:1. It says, cry aloud, spare not.
Mm.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people the transgression and the house of Jacob their sins. Which that goes into basically, you know, We speak loud. We say, hey, man, the Lord is coming back. He's going to destroy this place. He's going to send our enemies, you know, against us and punish us. We need to get right with the Heavenly Father before he just, you know, destroys you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's how we speak, you know, because basically what that scripture is talking about, the passion, man. You got to speak passionately, man. You got to feel these scriptures and feel these verses if you understand what's coming. If you understand what's coming, if you understand it's going to be martial law, if you understand that there's going to be, race wars, if you understand that the mark of the beast is the microchip and the Lord's going to destroy you for injecting it on your skin, you know, if you understand about World War III, it's going to lead to America's destruction. If you understand on that, right, and you also understand that there's a hope to be saved from all of that, you know, and others with you, then wouldn't you be, you know, be passionate about telling your people and warning them what's getting ready to happen?
Good.
But see, this just shows you that these other groups, man, they don't really have no real passion for the truth. They don't have no real love for Yahweh by Hashem Yahushua, you know? Because if they did, if they really cared about black people and the Hispanic Native American people, if they really cared about the tribes, then they would make it their business and do everything that they can to like scripture says, pull them out of that fire of judgment, man.
Good.
I want to see brothers make it. You want to see their families make it. You know what I'm saying? Hey, if we can save all our families, shoot, that would be a beautiful thing.
Right.
You know? And then we'd be talking to the elect and the one-third. But that's why there is importance stressed upon warning the people going out there on the highways and edges, man. How was I said that? He said, he told Peter three times, if ye love me, feed my sheep, man. Feed my lambs.
God. Hey, bro, just to add to your point about us, just in regards to the mark of the beast, not only do we tell you what the Lord is going to do if you take the mark of the beast, but we're going to intricate details in regards to that mark just not being good for you. Destroy your body, for one, for two, and most importantly, against the law, okay? Just to examples in regards to not taking the beast, taking the mark, including the ultimate one, your ass burned in nuclear fire. The men of the Lord are thorough, man. Just like any solid teacher worth their salt, man, they're thorough. They'll give you many examples, multiple ways. Okay, that's why the Lord said he speak through the prophets with similitude, man. We can give you a host of examples. Okay. We know how Jake learned to operate. We know.
Hey, niggas forehead, man. You got a goddamn cussing nigga out there.
That's why I mean Amaya did it. That's why other prophets did it, man.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you need a good scolding. I remember growing up, you know, my mom used to say, you ain't gonna do shit until I cut your ass out. You know, but that's how Jake is, man. And you like little kids that ain't even woke up to the fact of what's really going on. You know, we are children, but we know what the hell going on.
Yeah.
And we know it on the level to teach you.
Yeah. That's why they're going
you, to. You, the ones that ain't woke up yet, like hard-headed little badass kids, man.
Yeah.
And you need a good ass with or a good scolding. Either way, it's going to cut your spirit. Which way you want to take it? You want the actual fire or you want the spiritual fire? But you don't get it correct. You going to do what the Lord asks you to do.
Oh, you ain't going to have a choice. I was going to say that they're not going to have no choice, man. They're going to have to bow down to the Lord, man. In that day,
that's right.
they're gonna be forced to do what is you know what the Lord said he was gonna do. You know, they not gonna have no choice, man. All right, And when the missiles come, they not going to have no choice but to die because they didn't hearken unto the Lord, man.
That's right.
I got the scriptures for you.
Oh, yeah, cut.
All right.
Bring it out, bro.
This is the book. Con. You want to get this one? You can go ahead with yours. I'll read this one next.
Okay, Con, yeah. And this is just real quick, man. Deuteronomy 9 and 24. It says, ye have been rebellious against the Lord from the day that I knew you.
Mm.
Oh, man.
That's it. That's the spirit of Israelites, man. From day one, man, Jacob's has been rebellious, man. What do you think the Lord is going to do to a rebellious nation that keeps provoking them like that?
Yeah.
He's going to have his wrath kindled against them and destroy them, man.
That's right.
You know? That goes for these false prophets that's not doing the work of the Lord. Matter of fact, I got one more quick precept.
Come.
You know? This is Jeremiah 48. You know? Because, hey, these false prophets going to get their judgment. All right? And so are the two-thirds, man. For being rebellious. Okay? This is Jeremiah 48:10. It says, cursed be he that doeth the work of the Lord deceitfully. Okay? So for these teachers and these leaders and these elders of these different camps, these Israelite groups, okay, you're doing the work of the Lord deceitfully because you're holding back information. You're holding back key and pertinent information that pertains to the salvation of our people, man. Okay. It says, and cursed be he that keepeth back his sword from blood.
Yep.
You know? So you have to be willing and ready to warn the people of everything, man. Paul said, I have not shunned to declare to you all the gospel of the Lord. You know, I'm paraphrasing. So he gave them everything, name, okay, that by Yahweh Shai. Yahweh going to save a remnant of Israel and bring them back into the fold. That's what Paul was preaching. That's the same thing we say. You know? He warned them about, you know, the downfall of the Roman Empire and, you know, things coming in the future. But we have to be in that same mindset. We have to not be rebellious. Okay? But we have to do what the Lord said do. So for the Israelites that's not listening, you know, hey, the scripture says the rebelliousness is as a sin of witchcraft.
Mm.
And then it says, a witch shall not be suffered to live.
That's right.
You know? So you gotta, you gotta die.
Yeah.
You know?
That's right, bro.
Yeah.
I got a precept, bro. It's a young precept.
Okay.
That you brought out. This is Acts 7 and 51. It says, ye stiff necked and uncircumcised in heart, ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit. As your fathers did, so do you, or so do ye.
Yeah.
Okay? And that's exactly what the Bible is talking about. But the Lord even said, hey, you are your fathers.
Don't get too deep.
We'll start out right there.
And the video,
I got something for you. That ain't too deep.
I'm just messing with the brother.
Yeah. I got something, you know, for that because Jake needs to understand certain things, man.
Come.
Right, this is Lamentations chapter 5 and 7. It says, our fathers have sinned and are not, and we have borne their iniquities. So we carry the iniquities of our fathers all the way up until these generations, man. All the
way
up until now. You know?
That's right, bro.
Hey, and we was talking to Cam yesterday, man. Hey, Jay got BC sins, man. Mm. Jay got sins to go back in 400-500 BC. You know? Along with Esau. Esau got sins to go back to the BC times, man.
Yeah,
you know,
them sins and debt.
Because they're not covered by Yahweh Shai. You know?
God.
scriptures for you.
Come.
Alright. This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 30. I'm going to start at verse 15. It says, "See, I have set before thee this day life and good, and death and evil." Alright? And, you know, we our people have always chosen the path of destruction. Alright? Rebelliousness. Idol worshiping, you know, and it's even going back into the time of Moses, there was always a one third, because there was a group of people that always worshiped the Lord and never really went off like the rest of the nation did. All right, and you know, we read that in the book of Exodus. You know, it tells you about that the group that the Spirit put the Spirit of the Lord came onto a certain amount of people to hearken unto Him. You know. And the rest of the people was stuck on in their rebelliousness, all right. But the reason why I'm bringing out this scripture, damn, Satan fucking with this brother right now. You know, but you know, the reason why I'm bringing out this scripture is because the Lord always present us with, You still there?
Yeah.
All right, fine. Okay. Hold on. Let me. I'm gonna pause.
Yeah. So you bring back out that precept you had. All right.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15. It says, "See, I have set before thee this day life and good, and death and evil. In that I commanded thee this day to the Lord thy power to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments and his statutes and his judgments, that thou mayest live and multiply. And the Lord thy power shall bless thee in the land whether thou goest to possess it. But if thine heart turn away, so that thou will not hear, but shall be drawn away and worship other gods and serve them, I denounce unto you this day that ye shall surely perish." And that's going back in the history of our people, man. The Lord said he was going to destroy us if we went the other way. All right? And our people just, they love to go into the way of the wicked, man. And this is going back into the beginning, right? You know, our people are chosen the ways of the wicked. Even though the Lord told you he would fuck you up for it. You know, that's how hard-headed our people are, man. All right? And we're telling you that the Lord destroyed the two-thirds of the nation of Israel, man. And he told people he was going to do that back in the times of Moses. And, all right? It says, verse 18 again, it says, "I denounce unto you this day that ye shall surely perish, and that ye shall not prolong your days upon the land, whether thou passest over Jordan to possess it. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore choose life, that both thou seed may live." It says, this last verse, "Thou mayest love the Lord thy power, and that thou mayest obey his voice, and that thou mayest cleave unto him, for he is thy life and the length of thy days, that thou mayest dwell in the land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give them." That's the point. So, that's the point.
Yep. Let's see the Lord. See, the Lord, he's going to jack these rebellious Israelites up, man. Jack them up, and he's going to step. Let me get this scripture, because the Lord said he's going to jack these other rebellious Israelites up. But this is, you know, what he said about Israel anyway. Jeremiah 44:27. 26. It says, be the word of the Lord, all Judah will dwell in the land of Egypt. I have sworn by my great name, said Lord, that my name shall no more be named of any man of Judah and not of Egypt, in the Lord power limits. Behold, I will watch over them for evil and not for good, and all the men of Judah that are in the land of Israel will be driven by the famine until they're being that's too late. Right? And that's, and if you quit this to this, you know, hey, that's gonna happen again. That same spirit that the Lord came in back then is gonna bring it back into spiritual Egypt and consume these Israelites. All right, but this time you're going to have all 12 tribes here in Egypt, okay? Be destroyed, man. Two-thirds of them that don't turn back are going to be destroyed. It says, yeah, the small number that escaped the sword shall return out of the land of Egypt into the land of Judah, and the remnant of Judah that are gone into the land of Egypt to sojourn there shall know whose word shall stand, mine or theirs. So the Lord is going to have a remnant of Israel returning back, man. Okay? But he's always done against Jacob that didn't listen. He always punished him, man. So that punishment is going to have to come here. But see, the thing is now, the Lord, okay, he has this remnant that was shy to redeem him, man, forever this time. It's not like it was in the ancient world to where the prophets prophesied certain things, you know, evils, and then the Lord brought evils on us, and then we returned again, but we rebelled, and the Lord put us back in captivity again. Nah, this is not going to happen again, man. This time, our redeemer, Yahweh Shai, he's going to come back and he's going to slay Israel, man. He's going to slay us. But it's only going to be that remnant, man. It's only going to be that small few that are slated to escape. You know, like I knew earlier, that small crust of grapes. Everybody else is going to perish, man. You know?
John, I got something for you. All right. This is Zechariah 13:8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. And it's, you know, talking about, you know, the one third and the two thirds of the nation, man. All right, two thirds of the nation is gonna be destroyed, man. Yeah, it should be good.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, I'm gonna read it again for you. You know, come. It says Zechariah 13:8. It says, and it shall come to pass that in all the land, the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. All right, and that's talking about the one third. Saved, man. Third is being put to death. It says, all right, but at the same time, the one third, they're gonna scarcely make it. You know, they're gonna have to go through some things to obtain the salvation. Okay, verse 9, and I will bring the third part through the fire, and will refine them as silver is refined, and will try them as gold is tried. Which that means, you know, basically means to be made pure, all right, through the fire, and that fire is affliction. You know, it says they shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, the Lord Yahweh Bashim Hawashai is my power. All right.
Same calamities that everybody else in America is going to go through.
times. He only said it once. And kept moving. No, man. The Lord is using his men to bring it out in many different ways, man. One prophet was too hard to understand. Another one Paul was a hard man to understand, as Peter said. Paul's teachings was a stumbling block to some people, and there's evident today. The heathens, the heathens, they trip up Paul's teachings all the time.
Hey, 2013 all the time.
That's right. But that's why we have precepts of the Old Testament. As well, go back and show you what Paul meant. And even Peter himself said, misunderstand Paul, and it's going to be to the instruction. I'm not the creator of that.
Yeah, so what's the scripture?
That's right. So now, St. Peter's, I want to say, it's toward the end of that chapter.
Yeah, 3. 2 Peter 3, yeah. You know? But hey, it's only given to the elect anyway.
That's right.
Only the one third and the true men of the world can understand, can understand this truth. But like it says in Revelation, no man can learn the song except for the 144,000.
That's right.
That's right.
You know, only 144,000 can understand the song, man, you know?
Yeah.
Hey, what Yahweh shall say, bro? I pray for them. I pray not for the world.
Mm-hmm.
God, which God has given me, they are dying, and dying are mine, and mine are God.
Beautiful.
Yeah, same thing, bro.
Hey, you know, we coming down to,
that's right.
Fear the Lord. They shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and same chapter, those that fear the Lord are the seed of Jacob. It says, for they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Because it's going to be martial law, and they're going to be going door to door saying, this person's a terrorist, that person, extremist, and they're going to be going in and they're going to be calling you off to these different detention. You know?
Gone.
It says, verse 73 is the point. It says, then shall they know you are my chosen, and they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. You know, just like you read in Zechariah 13. Okay? Mm-hmm. All right? You know, the chosen, the elect, is going to be known who they are, man. It's going to be known who the elect are. It's going to be known who the men of the Lord were. It's going to be known who was chosen to be delivered, you know? To all these rebellious guys out there, man, the Lord got something for you, man. Okay? And it's called Jacob's Trouble.
That's right, bro. That's right.
Yeah, that's all I had, too. I don't know if anybody got any.
You know what?
Shalom.